Convenience store, one of those Chilla art games. I played this once before and I got the, I guess what you would call the bad ending where I died, so I'm going to play it again so I can get the other ending. And apparently I missed where you feed the homeless guy, so I'm going to try and get that as well. Here we go. Time. Need to get ready for work. Okay. Blah 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 blah.
Ah, outside it's dark, isn't it?
Okay. Change clothes? Sure. Okay. There's the convenience way off in the distance. And I'm supposed to get something to eat. Warm it up. Yep. And we'll go get the flashlight.
懐中電灯を持っていかないと危ないよね.
Yeah, it's dangerous outside. So, let's get the flashlight. The crusty, grungy range here. Yeah, I don't get this nasty apartment. I mean, I know they're trying to set a mood, but this is... Nobody would live like this. Sure. Eat the bento. And let's get going. Oh, let's turn the head bob off. I hate that. Ah, now that looks much better. I actually see now. Oh yeah, that's better. Yeah, so all the street lights work. That's my place up there. Or is it that one? I guess it's that one. You didn't tell me this before. I was called to warn you all. By the name I cannot speak of. Day of judgment will come. Yeah. Bring me food. Or you will receive eternal punishment. Okay. What's up, dude? With your weird face. God, you made it, hmm? And I was just, I recently heard someone fell off the bridge you just crossed. It was an old lady that said she saw a man walking down the street with his legs completely bent the other way. Scary stuff. If only that was a true story. Ha ha ha. Ha. Sorry. Okay. Yeah, it looks much better without that effect. What is up with your neck, dude? Weird. Them off the shelf for me, your manager. And let's clock in, sure. Yep. Okay, see you tomorrow. Shelf looks fine. Customer. Some recycling. Irashaimase. You didn't get any of that spoiled stuff. Okay. Let's take care of my stuff. Looks like summer expired. Take items off the shelf, yes. I wonder. Give this to this guy. Sure. There we go. $10 an hour night shift. Reason why I'm here. Shelf looks fine. Shelf looks fine. Shelf looks fine. Shelf looks fine. Looks like summer expired. Sure. Okay. Yeah, I'm coming. Thank you. Okay, Kuro Neko. She says delivery service. It's kind of late for a delivery man at this time. I recently incorporated this system exclusively convenience stores that are open late at night. Looks like this package is shipped directly to this store. Oh, and the name matches your tag. I think this is for you. That's weird. Thank you for always keeping the toilet clean, oddly convincing. Take it home, sure. That again. Okay. Go back to work. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, I could do without this part. Can't see anything down there either. Hey. So I heard you reported that the doors would open on their own. Well, we got a guy to check the sensor. Seems like the wiring was loose. I thought it was some sort of poltergeist. I see those on TV all the time, but they're all scripted. Ghosts aren't real, after all. Okay, what's next? I think it's the rats, yep. Someone must have left the garbage bin open. First person to see this note is to get rid of the rodents ASAP, your manager. Okay, let's punch in. See you, bruh. kid? No. Missed one. Where is it? Is it back here? I got that guy. Oh, it's in a corner. I'm so agonizingly slow. Hey, Grandma. I guess I can't do anything with you until you get where you're going to be. Metal juice, chop, you high. Does that say? Oh, ninja juice. Still in there. Get it yourself. Yep. I don't know why I have to carry these one at a time. That's annoying. There's Ken-kun. You know where Ken-kun is? Thought I heard his voice. This was my daughter's house. What did you do? How dare you? Okay. What's next? I saw some rats. Garbage bin open. Sure. Doesn't let me clean up the trash. Mr. Delivery Man. There's nothing there. Good to see you again. Okay, you know the unstoppable trend of ordering everything online. Anyway, seems to be a package that needs to be picked up here. And it magically appears. Okay. Sure. See you, bro. Stuck on it. There we go. Grab the umbrella. Okay. Who's knocking? Sure. Closely, sure. Okey-doke. actually much nicer to play without that terrible effect. Homeboy isn't here. Okay. Good, huh? Okay, fine, I'll stop. Promise I won't do it again. Oh, there we go, little kid. Busted the tape. Products are missing on the shelf. Always keep the shelves full. That's our motto. Please restock them by tomorrow morning, your manager. Let's clock in. Sure. See ya, bruh. Yeah, locked in. Okay. Who's here? Talk to you from here, huh? Sure. Can I? Hamada. Says something wrong with the air conditioning. Ibo seem desperate in keeping the food fresh. Hate to be working this late, but he pays me well, you know. Don't mind me. I'll just quickly check the outside units. Head right out. Okay. Anything else to stock? I think that's everything. Yeah, that's everything. Why is it raining inside? Hello, lady. Do you know it's raining inside? She is. Okay. Hey, are the only one working here? I can't believe this. What kind of a manager puts a girl on a midnight shift alone? I see you have no choice. Well, at the very least, I'll give you my protection charm. Now be careful. Take it, yes. Too bad it doesn't work. It's back here. Take the wrench. Open the AC. doke. Trapped in here. Sure. Okay. There we go out here. Sure. Manager. Okie doke. Is it a nightmare? Was it all a dream? And this part here just seems unnecessary. No time card and no coworker. CCTV, sure. Walking around already. Okay. If I remember correctly, it's this one. I think it's this one, and then is it this one? Yeah, it must be still on. Yeah, that must be right. Here it is. Pick it up. Last time I watched it, I got the bad ending. What do we do? Send it off to someone else. That's terrible, but sure. Ending one. Sickened by the whole situation, sealed the VHS tape carefully, decided to send it off to the sender. Fortunately, the sender's address was on the box. When I was done preparing to send it off, I felt my tense shoulders relax. Too much had happened in a short span. My mind couldn't keep up. I knew I had to rest, but I couldn't fall asleep. Everything about the store terrified me. Inevitably, I had to sit down on a chair and clear up my head. What did I see? Was everything I witnessed even real? Even though I was scared, I knew I had to know the truth. I wanted to know why, what had happened, and why. So I turned to the internet about the store. I found a few old articles and forums talking about the location of where the building was made. One comment on a strange forum stood out to me. It said, "Seemed to have been gruesome killings at this property." In search for the name of the user's comments, 2009, there was a case where a man who was the mainstay of the family committed a murder-suicide. I determined to investigate the incident further. The 14th, the man killed his child with a kitchen knife and while his wife was off for the grocery shopping. When the wife came back, it said she was killed in an extreme way. He then hung himself on the same day. Say that the woman was pregnant at the time of her death. The woman was killed with several nails punctured into her lung with her child in her stomach. I wanted to throw up from the obscene images, but I knew I had to continue. There was a guy that replied to the comment and said that he worked at the same place as him. According to him, the man was often harassed by his boss at work, and he had complained to several colleagues. The day of the incident, it said that he had an emotionless face. Imagining what the family had gone through, depression, hatred occupied my head. It was very painful. Tears in my eyes. Closed the internet gently. Called the manager to talk about everything I experienced during the night shift and what I had discovered. However, the calls were never picked up. It was the same over and over again. Then I received a phone call from Mr. Hosoi, franchise leader who I had never met. I had a bad feeling about it. Shivering voice, he said, "The manager is dead." I couldn't breathe, so it wasn't a dream. When I asked about the place where it was found, Mr. Hosoi said that there was an old storage behind a convenience store, and he was found there after a day of his death. I dropped my phone. I quit my part-time job with a broken feeling. To quitting, I would avoid going near the convenience store whenever I could, because every time I passed in front of the store, I would always feel the sharp stare towards me. I wouldn't be able to help but to try and pass as quickly as possible. So not looking at the building. A day later, the store closed down. The reason seemed to be poor management. Further details were not publicized. At that point, I didn't have the means or the courage to examine it anymore. After a while, the memories of the convenience store started to haze down a bit. One day, as I passed down the closed down store, I heard a child's voice. There I saw the woman. I looked in my hand. I had picked up one of the rusted nails that had fallen in the middle of the site. Okay. Game by Chilla's Art. What's up, buddy? Come here. Meow. Pop, pop, pop. Come here. It's a good boy. Psst, psst, psst. Come here. Psst, 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 psst. Psst, psst, psst. It's a good boy. Good boy. Thank you for playing. And thank you for watching. I'll be back soon. Take care. there we go. All right. Thank you for watching.